Welcome to That's Pretty Neat with Rodger and Stefan, where we discuss neat, holistic, regenerative agriculture.
In the whole grazing world, there are a lot of catchphrases. And there's rational grazing from Bozan, there's rotational grazing, there's time management, there's MIG management intensive grazing, there's ultra high density grazing, there's set stocking rate grazing. I could probably just go on and on with a list. But I think what's important to know is that all of the grazing systems don't work. We've researched them over the last 50 odd years, and we found where each of them fell down. And the reason they fall down is the same for all of them. Nature is too complex for any set system that you can repeat over and over again, which is what we humans like to do. So you can't move every Friday because then your recovery periods won't be long enough. You can't only do the ultra high density grazing. All of these things we've tried, if you try and put it into a system, it collapses. So what I've been training you to do and what we work on is holistic planned grazing, because your holistic planned grazing is connected to your quality of life. Then there's the side of, well, we've got to have a financial plan and we've got to make a profit. Well, if we build a whole bunch of fences everywhere, the fences aren't earning us any money. So it would have been better to have put the investment into livestock than into fencing. So that's a financial example. Social, financial, environmental. Often when we've changed how we graze a piece of land, we found the land has changed so much that we don't even recognize it. And I think we're sitting in a spot where you don't even recognize it. Did it look like this in the early years of you owning the ranch?
Nope, it was all gray and covered in leaves.
So under the trees, all gray, covered in leaves, no vegetation, and now it's a solid mat of green grass.
Yeah.
Basically almost as far as the eye can see. So that's an example. If we had made a grazing plan and built fences based on what you had then, that infrastructure now would have been in the way of what you're doing now. Mm-hmm. So holistic planned grazing is a way of thinking. It's a way of monitoring. It's a financial system attached to it. And it's taking cognizance of the fact that our ecosystems do change based on our management. And so once you find that, okay, we've been doing the same thing for the last 10 years and yeah, we always walk them down this road, well, then you might decide to put in a permanent fence, but there's really no need to. And now with virtual fencing coming online and all these other technology solutions, so now you've got humans who can herd. You've got humans who can train animals to have the instinct to stay and herd themselves. You've got electric fencing, you've got virtual fencing, you've got barbed wire fencing. There are so many different ways that we can achieve what we're trying to achieve for our quality of life. So that's what it comes back to, is what is our quality of life? And our quality of life is connected to our finances, and our finances are connected to our environment and our habitat. So rational grazing, that was the beginning of the thinking that bled into holistic planned grazing, because Bozan was the one who understood the importance of recovery periods so that these plants could grow without being grazed, without having any animal pressure. Now, this is a particularly good spot that we're sitting here, because if you look in the foreground here, you can actually see the deer have come behind the cattle. Yeah. And the deer are doing the trampling and the grazing now, even though there haven't been cows here in how many months? A couple?
Four
months. So yeah, so what we're seeing here is deer who are coming behind the cattle to come and pick the sweetest grazing. Now a management plan needs to be put in place to manage the deer, because they are part of the whole. Yeah. And they're affecting the whole. The previous rain was 6 weeks before this.
Yep.
So all of this really grew on a rainfall event 6 weeks ago. So there's been no rain for 6 weeks until this morning, and this stayed green and lush for 6 weeks just because the soil was holding all the moisture and we had such good mulch, and it's such a solid mat of grass because so many seeds got pushed under the ground by having the animals at density and with the right behavior. So this is what we're trying to achieve over your entire ranch.
Yes, it is.
You can follow Rodger at d2gftf.com and also on his socials at Rodger Savory Holistic Management on YouTube and Facebook. We are Las Cumbres Ranch. You can follow us on social media at Las Cumbres Ranch over all platforms. And thanks for tuning in. It's been real neat.